Being a Christian in an area in many parts of northern Nigeria that are predominantly Muslim comes with a very special package and a special baggage. That is largely because of the historical antecedents of the areas that now make up the 19 or so states of northern Nigeria. Those areas are coterminous with the boundaries of the former Sokoto Caliphate, which was in power from 1804 to 1903, almost exactly 100 years. There was a state that was a theocracy. And the result then is that the conquest of the British in 1903 left a very sour taste in the mouth. Since then, the remnant of the caliphate has continued to live with a sense of nostalgia, but also almost an imaginary culture that is still dominantly Muslim. And within that context, the modern Nigerian state has continued to create other dynamics and other dimensions. But the difficulties that Christians encounter in northern Nigeria arise from the fact that there are many majority of Muslims who almost behave as if the Sokoto Caliphate is still in existence, and who literally see themselves as living within a theocracy. No, matters have not been helped by the fact that the governors themselves have really not done much, especially in a democracy, to maximize the opportunity of managing pluralism and the kind of opportunities that democracy does offer us. So the lingering feeling that we are Muslims in a predominantly Muslim environment suddenly throw up the distortions and the feeling that being anything other than a Muslim makes you almost, if you like, an outsider. Now, it is the responsibility of the modern Nigerian state to manage the identities of minorities. So really, the question of the situation of Christians is really the larger question of minorities, whether they are women, or whether they are men, or whether they are children, or whether they are Muslims. Because like I often say to people, there are most parts of Nigeria that Muslims are almost non-existent, and other parts of Nigeria where Muslims are a minority. So really it's a question of what kind of architecture does a modern state design to be able to enhance pluralism, but also to create a sense of identity that is over and above ethnic or religious considerations.